Apparently it were that simple.
The worst kind comes without warning. A deep and primal signal from within.
A reminder that just because you cannot see the threat, it doesn't mean that it's not already here.
Find another route.
Truth says there's always another route.
Find a way somewhere. Go round somewhere.
Find your own path.
Yeah. Skoon! Yoivar! Zanbar!
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great curving eyebrows as walls.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? Your home, loved ones, to head deep into the wilds, perhaps never to return. Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything. Turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place.
She went to the wilds a long time.
Why did she go to the wilds?
She wanted to fight her own darkness. She thought she could beat her own
darkness. Did she beat her darkness?
No. It nearly killed her, but she tried.
Druth. Druth helped her.
If it wasn't for Druth, she'd be dead.
She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillion.
She thought her curse would affect him.
She thought her curse would spread to him. She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too.
She nearly died.
She thought the darkness came to him.
Druth helped her.
Northmen say you must sacrifice in order to receive. They tell how the runes were revealed to Odin only in sacrifice. He hung himself from the world tree, and he stabbed himself with a spear, and he dedicated the sacrifice to himself. For 9 nights he hung on the tree without food or drink, and at last he saw the runes below him. He gave a cry, and gathered them in his mind and learned them. Then he fell from the tree.
The ravens.
The ravens.
They've gone.
Sims have gone.
No.
Half of them have gone.
They've gone.
Some are still there.
But where?
Some are still there.
And how are ravens helping?
He's not helping.
It's a trick.
Quiet. Try. Can't think.
Out in the wilds. In the cold winter woods.
Where?
She no longer felt fit for this world. She almost gave in to the darkness. She remembered Dillian's words. She remembered her promise. She resolved to fight on and kill that which had become a part of her.
The gate is open!
Opened!
She didn't.
There is no such thing as victory when it comes to the darkness. It's like it doesn't want to kill me. Yet, I will gnaw at her, biding its time. Only when she is at her weakest will it strike to kill. Will she find Dillian? Before her time comes.
Overcome Valravan's final illusion to face him in his keeping. I know you can do it, Senua. You have the sight.
We both see the darkness. We can fight it together. Speak to me, Druth. Tell me a story.
Senua, listen. I will tell you the tale of a man called Findan. The Northmen captured Findan's sister, and his father sent him to pay for her release. But they took his gold, put him in chains, and held him for a day and a night without food or water. Then they released him. I don't know why. Upon his return, his father's enemies in Erin set fire to his home. His father burnt to death, and his brother was killed. But he escaped with sorrow in his heart. His father's enemies offered redress for his loss and invited him to a feast. It was at a hall near the sea. But when he went there, they betrayed him to the Northmen, who enslaved him and took him to hell. 6 years later, his slave masters landed on the shores of Orkney, burning all before them. And into that fire, Findon made his escape. What was Findon burnt away that day? But from the flames, a new man stepped forward, and Druth was born. Druth, the man that I am now. And though Findon never set eyes on his dear sister again, I, Druth, have found you, Senua.
I wish you could have seen my home before these dark times.
Gate is open!
Wait, open!
It's darkness. I know it from the wilds. It's coming back for me.
Are you still here? Are you too? I remember. It didn't end well in the wilds. It never does. You think you can overcome the darkness, make sense of it, and once relief settles in, it strikes out of nowhere, throwing you helplessly back into the maelstrom. Drowning the mind in fear, deeper, deeper, dragging you down so far into the void that maybe this time there is no coming back. But there, in the darkness,
Senua,
and she remembered what he told her.
Hear me, reach out to me. Senua, take my iron mirror, look into it. For it is a window into the underworld. Within, you will see the face of the darkness that you fear. And if you focus, like I have taught you to, you will also see that as much as the darkness has you trapped within its veil, it too is trapped within yours. Focus! Focus! Focus!
I see you now. You led me to the wilds. You trapped me there.
Behind you!
Valravan, one of the keys to the gate to Helheim. Hold it in your mind's eye.
With every battle, the darkness grows stronger. Every victory, bringing her closer to defeat. Unfair, isn't it? In those dark winter nights in the Whites and the Wilds, there were times when she considered letting go. If it weren't for truth, a chance encounter in the wilds, she would not have heard his stories of the Northmen. And she would not have this chance to find Dillian's soul.
I'm coming.